I want to talk about the oil spill. Seems to keep popping up. Seems to be the main story, really, if you have to pick one. It's environmental. It's economic. It's science and technology. It's even spiritual and religious. People think that this type of a thing was written into the divine plan somehow. So I know I'm running a mystery channel, but let's get to that later. Let's just stick with the facts. I'm going to make several recommendations here, and let's see if we can have a collective consciousness going out. So whoever listens to this, if you agree, just keep perpetuating these ideas. I basically gathered up as much as I can of what people are suggesting and all the different information, the media reports coming out. None of my ideas are original, but I'm basically formulating to what I hope happens. I never would have wanted something like this to happen, a reality of the system of the world, okay? And let me make it really clear, what I'm saying is that the people in charge and who are running things, I feel really sorry for you. President Obama wants to go out and kick some ass, but doesn't know whose ass to kick. Some people are saying, well, he should start by kicking his own ass, and then maybe former President Bush and Cheney. But in any case, you see that them really should not be in the position that they're in, should not have authority, should not have the ability to do such things. But we, the people of the world, are at the whim of these maniacs, lunatics, greed mongers, overgrown, spoiled little brats. Okay, so that's enough of the anger, in the same way that the president was attempting to look at it and take some of the pressure off of himself, because, I mean, people are dissatisfied with the reports now, that the public is just not feeling that he's doing a good job. And this is worse than Katrina. This is 10 to 100 times worse than Katrina. What's worse than terrorism? What's worse than hurricanes or multiple hurricanes hitting the continental U.S.? What's worse than a recession? Well, the answer is the oil spill. And people in the beginning, I'll give you one example. Britt Hume on his news program, he's one of the anchors, one of the reporters there. Look up, if you have time to do some extra research, just to show you what idiots are out there. And that he made the statement that, the ocean crust is always leaking out oil, you know, this is a typical thing, this is nothing unusual or nothing at all to worry about. It's just something that the ocean, he didn't use the word biosphere, but something that the biosphere will take care of. No worries. First of all, I'm going to recommend that you lose your job. Second of all, you bury your head so deep into the sand that no one will ever see you or hear your fucking mouth again. You're an idiot. Okay, now, back to being calm. We do not want the authorities of the world, with all their fancy toys and their stupid decision making, to hit this thing with a nuke or any kind of explosive device. That is not a solution. I'm going to tell you why. Because they are creating instability in the crust in that area. And this is not some bizarre, unfounded scenario. The reason why it cannot be looked at that way and cannot be doubted is because the pressure that's coming out of this leak, this gusher, is beyond anything that's ever been seen before. This is kind of like if you were to go to Yellowstone, where they have Old Faithful, which is a geothermic site that has typically eruptions of certain pressure, and it goes out into the air. Now, you know, if we could see this, we cannot see what's going on. That's why they've been able to hide this and to cover their asses. It's under the water. It's under almost 1 mile of water, and that pressure, even regardless of that pressure of the water, this gusher is coming out like you can't even imagine. I've heard it's anywhere from 50 to 70,000 pounds pressure per square inch, PSI. Okay, I mean, if you can just imagine that, that means if you were to see it on the ground level, not underneath all the water of the Gulf of Mexico, which is, you know, for all intents and purposes, is an oceanic body. If it's not under such massive water, and you put one of those, such as what you see at Old Faithful in Yellowstone, this thing would be shooting up into the air for hundreds of miles, spraying this black gunk. It's a different kind of oil also. It has a lot of different properties. Supposedly, it's saturated with things like vanadium and different other minerals that you don't typically find in the oil deposits in the typical oil wells in Texas or wherever it might be, even in Russia, because they have a lot of facilities going on. So you're talking about this black gunk continuously erupting out. It is like a volcano that is continuous with the matter that's coming out of it and the toxic gases that accompany this. Shooting out with that much pressure all across the planet, the water and the oceanic currents are going to carry it as far as it will go. It cannot be shut off. Now, back to my point is why you can't hit it with a nuke or any explosive force, because it'll blow it open wider, and that will, in effect, destroy all the oceans of the world. And that's probably 1/3 of the food supply. So it'll kill off billions of people. Even if they don't hit it with an explosive force. Now, I didn't explain why. The reason, the logical reason why you can't solve it that way. Because it's just going to blow the thing open wider. It's not going to melt it over. It's just not going to do that. That's like a kid, like, I mean, like, you know how kids, like, do crazy antics with things? I mean, like, I know because I did it myself. You never can solve anything that way. No technology or solution comes out of that. That's just child's play. What it's going to crack it open, and that pressure from underneath the crust and into the mantle and even the magma is just going to force up so much it's going to rupture the plate and the coastlines, and it'll have numerous cracks going in every direction that it can. And that's why you don't want to do it. That's why you want to minimize it and just try to devise a capturing mechanism that is going to deal with this relatively smaller opening that there is. And we don't want to open it up any further. So this is my suggestion. This is my advice. And I just hope that that's what ends up happening, because it's really bad enough.